What's going on, guys? It is Bernardo from the BTNHD, and today is all about installing SmartDeploy client on Windows 10. So let's get started. First things first, on part one, I showed you guys how to install SmartDeploy console with no problems. So hopefully you guys are up and running on that part. So we are going to click on start, and we are going to go all the way to the bottom where it says SmartDeploy, open up the folder and click on SmartDeploy to launch the console. And again, for me, for some reason, I kept on saying do not show again. I hit yes, and it just kept on popping up for me. Eventually, it's going to like kick in and say, okay, I got you. I understand. So hit do not show again and just hit yes on that particular dialog box, okay? So we need to generate a SmartDeploy client. So what we are going to do is click on Add Devices. Click on the button that says Generate Client Installer. Automatically, it is going to pre-populate your console server name. Best practice is to use the server name. Do not use the IP address. For my environment, I wanted to do a full qualified domain, so I just added .btnhd.edu. I clicked on Browse, and I wanted to drop everything inside my desktop, and I clicked on Save, and then I pressed OK. Once everything is done, you're going to get this nice little dialog box that says the client installer was created successfully. Click OK. Right, and then now you have the client on the desktop. Within my Hyper-V, I created a virtual machine, a Windows 10 machine. I called it BTNHD-SD-1. SD stands for, you guessed it, SmartDeploy, and it's the first machine. That MSI file that we created within SmartDeploy, I dropped it inside the desktop, and I right-clicked on it and clicked on Install. It's going to start preparing itself to install. You're going to get the nice SmartDeploy client wizard. Click Next here. Accept the license and terms, click next. The installation file already has the server name of where you have your SmartDeploy, so it's going to be pre-populated here. Click next, install. It's gonna start installing. You're going to get the user account control. Just hit yes on that to continue. It's gonna start creating the folders for you. You're gonna get a command prompt. Don't freak out, it's still doing its thing behind the scenes. And eventually when everything is done, you get this completed, click on finish. So from here, if you right click on your start menu, and go to Control Panel, and within Control Panel, if you go inside Programs and Features, you're going to see that the SmartDeploy client is already installed onto this machine. For those individuals that want to install this client silently or during MDT deployment or SCCM, or you want to do a GPO, whichever way you want to do it, this is the command that you will run to do it quietly within your environment, all right? You can also add this during your deployment, okay? So every machine that you have within your environment should have this client installed. Because one, it will allow you to push out applications, it will allow you to update drivers and also deploy images. So this client is extremely important to have on your machine. Once your client is already installed within your machine, for me, within my environment, I installed it into two machines, and you are able to go inside Computer Management. You're going to get this nice little dialog box to welcome to Computer Management. And from my experience dealing with this, I had a lot of issues for my machines to show up within the computer management. It took forever to show up. Eventually, once you click got it, and it takes you over here to all computers. Like I was saying before, it took forever for these machines to show up. It took almost a day. I find it kind of strange that the machines took forever to show up here. There's a lot of network requirements that you need to do for the client and the console to start talking together. So everything could work seamlessly. Also, the SmartDeploy must also be able to reach the two following URLs, which are right there in the bottom. But I kind of find it strange that those two machines took forever to show up within the computer management, regardless that the console and the client automatically installs a rule within your firewall to allow access. And that's it, guys. That is how we install the SmartDeploy client on a Windows 10 machine. Hopefully you guys enjoyed this video. Make sure to hit that like button. Also punch, elbow, smash that subscribe button to get the latest and greatest from this guy. Also share out the video, and I catch you guys on the next one. Peace out.